How many times have you thought about what your ex is thinking when you implement no contact? Hi, I'm Coach Abby. Thank you so much for tuning in to Love Advice TV. Love Advice TV is a channel developed for the sole purpose of helping you navigate different relationship issues. Let's focus a little bit on this, simply because it's probably one of the most asked questions. Coach Abby, are they thinking? Is he moving on? Is she completely decided to just not focus on our relationship anymore? And let me break it to you softly. The first thing that they're thinking is relief. And it sounds counterintuitive, but yes, relief, simply because by the time you enter into a no contact situation, you've had issues in the relationship. People get extremely exhausted dealing with the drama that comes most of the time before the breakup. With that said, add to that, if you were needy or clingy, they feel the sense of relief that they don't have to satisfy your emotional needs. So it's very important to understand that initially they feel a sense of relief, but that doesn't mean that it stays that way. Actually, they will find themselves all of a sudden becoming extremely curious as to, how could they have forgotten me so soon? And the ego kicks in. And normally when that happens, obviously, it triggers within them this need to make themselves present, mark their territory, make sure that in and of itself, one is really not moving on. The fear of losing their ex is quickly right there beside them at this point. And with that, it's, again, the territorial issue. People break up, and what they really want is to, even if they don't act upon it, they would love to be begged to go back. They would love to be pleaded. No contact avoids all that. So what normally comes to mind is, they've moved on. They found someone new. It's an internal fear. And most of the time, this is when they reach out. But what is important, and I think that this, if anything that I can really emphasize on this video, what is important is not what they think. It's how and what you are doing. You cannot lead from behind. You have to take the no contact as a time allocated for your own personal transformation, to become the best version of yourself, to show through example that you have a life, that you are not sitting at home waiting for that text to come or that phone call to come. You are allowing them to feel that challenge, to entertain that fear. It's very, very important because in general, we all want something that we can't have. And that's the beauty of the no contact. They find themselves isolated. They don't know how to reach out because they don't want to come across as weak. But it also allows us to come from a position of strength. And strength is very seductive. So most of the time when we do implement no contact, we do it with the intention of, I wonder what they're doing. And we worry so much about that. And we focus on that. And once again, when we do that, we're really taking away the privilege, the time allocated for ourselves, because we're so worried about them. So we're so worried about them. We focus on their actions, on their responses. And in essence, we're losing this wonderful opportunity to work on ourselves, to become the best version of ourselves, so that when they do reach out or when it is time to break the no contact, you show yourself in a complete different light. And then the whole dialogue changes. It becomes positive. It becomes seductive. It becomes a new relationship has the opportunity to evolve. Please make sure to hit the subscribe button below, and I invite you to book a coaching session with me. I think that together we can decipher the uniqueness of your breakup. And with that, I have a better impression of exactly what it is that they're thinking. It's important. It's important for you to understand that it's more about yourself and not about them. Until next time, I'm Coach Abby.